We talked about Saban and getting involved in his conversation. And Gene Wojciechowski has the story of a team that's not in the conversation for the playoff bracket. But, Gene, it's a story of power and politics and money at UAB that may have a very sad ending for them.
Well, Chris, this should be a time of celebration for UAB football. They're bowl eligible for the first time since 2004. Home attendance has more than doubled since last year. And yet, UAB coaches are looking for new jobs, and the players are looking for new teams, all because of a decision that blindsided a program that thought it had finally turned the corner.
We have made the decision that the 2014-15 academic year will be our final year of competition in football, rifle, and bowling. We've just come from meeting with our coaches and students and sharing this information with them. As you might imagine, a great deal of passion and emotion was exhibited.
I have a wife, a 3-year-old son. My son asked me last night, Daddy, what are they going to do with that program? And you telling me because the numbers didn't look right? It's 18-year-olds in here, 17-year-olds. What are they supposed to do?
UAB President Ray Watts helped pull the financial plug on football, saying the school could no longer sustain the cost of the program. Rumors had become reality, and reality became rage.
This guy had 3 surgeries last year. I can't tell you how many surgeries this team has gone through, man. To play for this team, put on these colors, to put this emblem, and represent college football.
That was beyond tough. I mean, these are guys that are your family, and it's really hard to put into words, really.
It isn't hard to put into words for Birmingham businessman Don Heyer, who has donated millions of dollars to UAB and vows to withhold millions because of the decision to end football.
I've never been more ashamed, more embarrassed in my whole life of a group of administrative people who had the ability to do something better than what we did that day. I feel so sorry for those players.
It was unreal just to see so many grown men break down and cry, and to see his reaction or lack of reaction, it turned your stomach. It almost made you wonder, you know, if you really cared.
If I had that to do over again, I would give anything to have the opportunity to really share heart to heart what this means to both of us and share our disappointment to one another.
3 days before the program was eliminated, the Blazers beat Southern Miss for their 6th win, tripling its total of a season ago.
This is going to be his 4th return for a touchdown, and that'll tie the NCAA record.
I'm thinking, like, if we win this game, we can save our program. We can go to a bowl game. We can put our school on the map.
3 weeks ago, 4 weeks ago, we'd kind of, had an idea that this might happen. I thought up to the last second that we could save it.
Watts says the program would have required a $49 million infusion during the next 5 years.
Nobody has come forward with a firm commitment of any additional resources. And we've asked, and if the checks were in the bank, it would be one thing. We cannot leave this university on promises.
But critics say Watts didn't consult with the school's biggest supporters.
Can you imagine making a decision to kill a program, yet you don't talk to your top donors, you don't talk to former players, you don't talk to the alumni, you don't talk to the city? How much data really went into this decision?
In my particular case, and I went and asked, and I was never given the opportunity to say I would contribute or not contribute.
Would you have?
I sure would have.
Since the announcement, Watts has been the subject of artistic expression and protest rallies.
UAB, so set us free and home, and home at UAB.
If Dr. Watts were sitting where I'm sitting, what would you guys say to him?
Stand up. Do what's right. You know what's right. Fix this.
For UAB coaches and players, all that remains is the slim hope of a bowl invitation.
Deep ball has a man! Touchdown!
In my heart, I still think we can fix this program, and maybe bit a bowl game can help.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe everybody, the world seeing UAB play one more time,
give us a chance.
Will give us another chance.
Just one more time being able to play, that'd be my Christmas.
Supporters said they went to Ray Watts and had certified checks, certified pledges for $5 million, and they said they could raise more if they would get a commitment that the program would remain in place. They said that they did not get that commitment. And Chris, while we were there filming those interviews, coaches from around the country were flying into Birmingham. One coach told me it was a coaches' convention at the Birmingham airport. They were camped out outside academic buildings waiting for those players to recruit them. Even in the football facility parking lot, it was a surreal scene.
Well, Joe, thank you. That is a footnote. Doesn't take long for coaches to try to go spot talent. At least the players will have an opportunity to play football, go somewhere else. But boy, without knowing every detail of that story, it's a complicated one. You feel for those guys who are screaming and yelling and crying.
Yes.
Been at UAB here, by the way. Or...
It's an example of politics really just destroying collegiate sports. The behind the door dealings of collegiate sports, and those young men, they suffer because of it. That should never happen in a program like that, never.
I think it's a great example for fans at home to get caught up in the who should be in the Final Four about what college football is really about. To see the emotion, the passion from these players standing up, talking to their president about what this program means to them, what playing football means to them, representing their school means to them. That was a great testimony to me of what really college football is all about.
And it's a business decision, the money.
Yeah.
But I tell you what, something behind the scenes is working there. Mark my words, it'll come out soon or later.
All right, well, you said it in different ways. What college football is all about. Some positive things, some negative things as well. But in the spirit of contributions that will not be made, in respect for that story, I will not contribute $100 to the guy who gets this question right, if anybody does. But you know how rare that is? To cancel an FBS or Division 1A program? You know the last program that canceled football?
Xavier.
No, that's not what I'm looking for.
No.
Do you know what Pete Carroll's alma mater is?
Pacific.
Yeah. Oh, that was the last program. It was not FBS. It was Division 1A at the time. They canceled football. That's how rare it is to do what was done at UAB.
I thought it was Xavier because when I was in Indiana, I went and got myself a defensive tackle.